हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल हैव बीन डूइंग वेल। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट अमाइट टाइप, अमाइट पार्ट टू। सो दिस इज माय लेक्चर नंबर 28 एंड इन दिस अमाइट पार्ट टू वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द जर्नल मेथड ऑफ प्रिपरेशन ऑफ अमाइट्स, देयर आइडेंटिफिकेशन टेस्ट, हाउ वी कुड आइडेंटिफाई अमाइट्स इन आवर लेबोरेटरी एंड वॉट आर दी फार्मास्यूटिकल एप्लीकेशन ऑफ अमाइट। वी वुड ऑल्सो स्टडी द जर्नल एप्लीकेशन, हाउ इन आवर डेली लाइफ वी यूज अमाइट, देयर फार्मास्यूटिकल एप्लीकेशन, देयर इंडस्ट्रियल एप्लीकेशन। सो एज कंसर्न विद दिस लेक्चर, दिस इज ए लेक्चर ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल केमिस्ट्री, ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री। सो आई रोट हियर द फार्मास्यूटिकल एप्लीकेशन ऑफ अमाइट। हाउएवर वी कुड ऑल्सो स्टडी और डिस्कस अबाउट दी मेडिसिनल एप्लीकेशन, इंडस्ट्रियल एप्लीकेशन, जर्नल एप्लीकेशन टुगेदर विथ फार्मास्यूटिकल एप्लीकेशन ऑफ अमाइट। एंड इन माई प्रीवियस लेक्चर दैट वॉज अमाइट पॉइंट पार्ट वन, प्लीज काइंडली मस्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस लेक्चर अमाइट पार्ट टू। मस्ट वॉच द लेक्चर नंबर 27, दैट इज अमाइट पार्ट वन। इन दैट आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस विद यू अबाउट वॉट आर दी अमाइट्स, देयर इंट्रोडक्शन, वॉट आर देयर टाइप्स, एंड वॉट आर दी क्लास, हाउ वी कैन क्लासीफाई दी अमाइट्स, एंड वॉट आर दी फिजिकल एंड केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ अमाइट्स। सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दी सिंथेसिस ऑफ अमाइट, हाउ वी कैन सिंथेसाइज और प्रिपेयर अमाइट इन अवर लेबोरेटरी। सो वन ऑफ द मोस्ट सिंपलेस्ट मेथड ऑफ प्रिपरेशन ऑफ अमाइट, हियर द कपलिंग ऑफ अ कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड विथ एन अमीन। सो वॉट इज इट हियर एज द दिस रिएक्शन इंडिकेटिंग दैट इन दिस रिएक्शन मीन्स इन दिस मेथड वी प्रिपेयर अमाइट बाय दी एडिशन और दी कपलिंग ऑफ दी कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड विद एन अमीन। वी कैन सी हियर दिस इज अ कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड आर सी ओ टू एच। सो इफ वी वॉट इज दिस आर सी ओ टू एच, दिस इज अ कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड। इफ दिस आर इंडिकेटिंग एन अल्काइल ग्रुप, मिथाइल इथाइल मिथाइल इथाइल ग्रुप फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ इट इज हियर सी एच थ्री एंड सो वॉट इट वुड बी सी एच थ्री सी ओ ओ एस ओ टू हियर, सो इट वुड बी सी एच थ्री सी ओ ओ एच। सो सी एच थ्री सी ओ ओ एच इज द मॉलिक्यूलर फॉर्मूला ऑफ कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड। सो दिस इज द कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड हियर एंड वॉट इज इट इज डूइंग, इट इज डूइंग रिएक्शन विद एन अमीन। हियर इट इज आर आर डैश आर डबल डैश मीन्स दिस इज अ आर ग्रुप हियर। इट मे बी आर मे बी मिथाइल इथाइल, सो इट हियर आर टू टू अल्काइल ग्रुप एंड एंड दैट इज अटैचिंग टू एन एच। सो वॉट इज दिस अमीन? सो दिस कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड कपल्ड विद इज दिस अमीन एंड आफ्टर दिस कपलिंग वॉट वी गेट अमाइड हियर। सो यू कैन सी हियर दिस इज आर ग्रुप सी ओ एन आर डैश एंड आर डबल डैश। सो एज यू रिमेम्बर इन माई लेक्चर नंबर 28, इन दैट वी स्टडी अबाउट दी अमाउट अमाइट पार्ट वन, इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दी अमाइट। सो इन इंट्रोडक्शन आई एक्सप्लेन यू दैट वॉट आर दी अमाइट ऑन एंड वॉट इज देयर जर्नल फॉर्मूला। सो अमाइट इन दी दिस इज द जर्नल फॉर्मूला ऑफ अमाइट मीन्स इट आर इस अमाइट आर हैविंग अमाइट आर दी ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड दैट आर फॉर्म बाय दी रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ अ हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप फ्रॉम एन कार्ब फ्रॉम अ कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड एंड एडिशन ऑफ अमाइन ग्रुप इन रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप इन दी कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड एंड दे आर हैविंग द जर्नल फॉर्मूला आर सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ एन आर डैश एंड आर डबल डैश। सो वन ऑफ द मोस्ट सिंपलेस्ट मेथड फॉर द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ अमाइड इज दैट वी कपल कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड विद एन अमाइन एंड वी गेट अमाइड एज अ प्रोटेक्ट। So the second method of preparation of amide is the Ugi reaction, and this reaction is based on the name of a scientist who discovered it. So the name was, the scientist was Ivar Carel Ugi, and I'm sorry if I am not pronouncing it's his correct name, because you know there are different type of pronunciation are available for different names. So as I can read his, it is Ugi reaction. So this the scientist Ivar Carel Ugi identify means developed this reaction during 1959. And what is this reaction? This reaction is actually a multi-component reaction. And what is this multi-component reaction? Multi-component reaction is a reaction in that more than one component. What are the component in a chemical reaction? Component are the reactant. So the a multi-component reaction is that reaction in that a multi-component reaction is a reaction in that more than one reactant. More than one reactant means more than one different reactant react together, and that they form a product. So in this reaction, we are seeing that in Ugi reaction, how we can form amide by the Ugi reaction. In this reaction, what will happen? A ketone or an aldehyde. Here in this case, we are having a ketone and an amine. Here it is, we are having an amine, a carboxylic acid, and isocyanate. These four reactant would react with each other, and then they will form amide. And in during this reaction, a water molecule would be removed from all these reactant. So what is this Ugi reaction? Ugi reaction is a multi-component reaction. What is the multi-component reaction? A multi-component reaction is a reaction in that more than one different reactant react with each other and form a product. And what is this Ugi reaction? In Ugi reaction is a reaction in that a carboxylic acid, here a carboxylic acid, a amine, a ketone or aldehyde. Here we are having a ketone and a isocyanate would react together, and they remove with the removal of a water molecule, they form an amide. So you just have to remember this, that in Ugi reaction, this is a multi-component reaction, and in this reaction, four different reactant, isocyanate, a ketone, or aldehyde, an amine or a carboxylic acid would react with each other, and then with the removal of water, they form an amide. Now, the second method of preparation of amide are Chapman reaction. This reaction is also named on the scientist who discovered it. In my all lecture, throughout from lecture number one to till now, for the for explaining you the synthesis of any compound, for example, I'm delivering you lecture from the alkane, alkene, alkyne, and till here then amide. Whatever method of synthesis I explained in front of you, every time I choose all those reaction that was based on the name of a scientist, so you can be able to easily memorize it. So you can easily remember that how we can we can prepare amide in laboratory. We can prepare amide by Ugi reaction. We can prepare amide by Chapman reaction. We can prepare amide by reacting carboxylic acid with amine. So this is for your ease, because you student are getting so much difficulty to remember to remember the reaction, because I am delivering a lecture about many different types of organic compound, and you have to keep remember all type of organic compound, how they synthesize, how what they do in chemical environment and physical environment. So for your ease, I use, although all the organic compound can be synthesized by many different types of reaction. Many different type of reactions are available on net in different books, but here I just choose a top most reaction, or top, you can say, easy reaction, or top top all those top reaction that are based on the name of a scientist, so you can easily remember them. So in the Chapman reaction, what is this Chapman reaction? Actually, in this Chapman reaction, what this scientist Chapman do to produce amide? So what he do? He heated an aryl benzimidate. This is an aryl benzimidate. It is a chemical reactant. So what did this Chapman do? This Chapman heated or thermally or give the heated this an aryl benzimidate, and then because of this heating, what did he get as a product? He get an amide. So what this heat means does with this an aryl benzimidate? This heat convert means this benzimidate, an aryl benzimidate, into an amide. So whenever, dear student, whenever you are having sign of this delta, it means the heat. You just have to keep remember, whenever you are seeing this sign of delta, it means the reaction is proceeding in the presence of heat. So what does Chapman do? He does not do any means he does not do any rocket science. He just heated this an aryl benzimidate, and due to the this heating, the N aryl benzimidate means rearrange or convert itself from N aryl benzimidate into an amide. So this is very simple method of preparation of amide. You just, whenever you have are having task of from your teacher to prepare amide in laboratory, what you have to do? You have to just take this an aryl benzimidate. You have to give the you have to heat this an aryl benzimidate. So as a product, what you would get? You would get an amide. So the other reaction is a Ritter reaction. It is also based on the name of a scientist. And in this reaction, what happened? An alkene. Alkene, what is alkene? I also have explained you already in my lecture of alkene, very previous lecture, that alkene are the organic molecule or organic compound that are having this triple bond. So what this Ritter do? Ritter the Ritter react with this alkene in the presence with the hydro strong or concentrated acid, that is sulfuric acid. So this or in the presence or the with water. So this alkene in the presence of sulfuric acid or with the water, what it will make? It will make an amide, or it will produce amide. So in this reaction, in Ritter reaction, what you are having as a reactant, you are having a alkene, an alkene as a reactant. And this alkene in the presence of sulfuric acid or and the water form amide. Or in other word, you can say this alkene is a nitrile. And this reaction, Ritter reaction, is a chemical reaction that transform a nitrile into an alkyl amide. So this is a nitrile. This Ritter reaction transform दिस नाइट्राइल दैट इज एन अल्कीन इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ वाटर एंड सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड एंड इट ट्रांसफॉर्म व्हाट दिस नाइट्राइल ट्रांसफॉर्म इंटू एन अल्काइल अमाइड इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड एंड वाटर. सो दिस इज वॉट द रिटर रिएक्शन दैट इज बेस्ड ऑन द नेम ऑफ द scientist that is Ritter. So another reaction for the synthesis or preparation of amide in the lab is a Passerini reaction. This reaction is also based on the name of a scientist, and it is again you can say it is a multi-component reaction because in this reaction we are having more than one different reactant or component. So in this Passerini reaction, you are having an a ketone, or you can also use here aldehyde, but here in the case right now I am having a ketone. So this ketone and the carboxylic acid and the this isocyanide, all these three component when react with each other, they form alpha acyloxyamide. This is amide. So you just have to remember that this Passerini reaction is a reaction that is a multi-component reaction, and in that a carboxylic acid and ketone or aldehyde or isocyanide would react with each other and they form an amide that is alpha acyloxyamide as a product. Now we are going to study about the identification test of amide, how we could identify amide in our laboratory. So in our lab we can easily identify amide by the sodium hydroxide solution. So what we have to do for this, we have to take unknown solution in test tube that would be having may be having amide, but we would not know about that what is inside the test tube. So if we add sodium hydroxide solution in that test tube, so what would happen if the solution, unknown solution, is having amide? So what would be happen? The ammonia gas would produce. So if the ammonia gas would produce, we would be adding a little bit of hydrochloric acid. So what would be happen if the amide is present in the test tube? The ammonia and the hydrochloric acid would form ammonium chloride gas. So this, the ammonium chloride gas, is the identification of amide in the solution, or presence of amide in the solution. And now we are going to study about the application of amide. So first we are seeing that how we use amide in our daily food. Amide and where amide are present in our daily food? Amide are present in the black pepper in the form of piperine. So piperine is an active ingredient of a black pepper, and it is a characteristic ingredient of the black pepper. It is present in the it is a amide, or it is present in black pepper. And amide is also present in chocolate as anandamide. So here we are seeing the structure of anandamide. You, dear student, you don't need to confuse with the structure, and you don't need to memorize the structure. You just have to understand that where we found the amide in our food. And then caffeine is also an a type of amide, and it is present in coffee and tea. So when you are having a coffee and tea, you have to remember that you are also having an amide in the caffeine. And one important thing, that all these compound, piperine that we get from black pepper, anandamide that we are having from chocolate, and caffeine that we are having from caffeine or coffee or tea, all these compound are having बायोलॉजिकल इम्पोर्टेंस और बायोलॉजिकल एक्टिविटीज। सो इन फार्मेसी और इन इन मेडिसिन वी आर हैविंग पेंसिलिन जी दैट इज अ अमाइड। सो व्हाट इज दिस पेंसिलिन जी? पेंसिलिन जी इज एन एंटीबायोटिक एंड इट इज यूज फॉर बैक्टीरियल डिजीजेस एंड दिस इज बेस्ड ऑन अमाइड मॉइटी। दिस इज अ अमाइड। नाउ इन इंडस्ट्री वी यूज अमाइड एज पॉलीमर। केवलर इज अ पॉलीमर एंड इट इज अ अमाइड एंड ऑल्सो नायलॉन 6-6 इट इज ऑल्सो अ पॉलीमर एंड इट इज अ अमाइड। सो नाउ माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर योर अटेंशन एंड दीज आर सम रेफरेंसेज। हियर यू कैन ऑल्सो गो थ्रू दी बुक आई एल फाइनर इफ यू विश टू स्टडी मोर अबाउट दी अमाइड एंड हियर सम वेब लिंक्स। यू कैन ऑल्सो गो थ्रू दीज वेब लिंक्स टू अंडरस्टैंड मोर अबाउट अमाइड। थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर योर काइंड अटेंशन एंड बी सेफ फ्रॉम कोविड-19। अल्लाह हाफिज।